ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Thursday night of the Toorak-Prahran presentations for season 19-20. Look, I just want to again thank Dougie for last night's presentation, and well done to all those recipients of the Thirds Awards. Tough season, no doubt. But hopefully, as I said earlier, that we'll be looking to put a lot of effort into the Thirds this year, and I expect we'll have a good turnout for the Thirds in the next season or the season to come. Tonight, we move on to the first 11, and again, I had a fantastic season. What can you say? I believe I was speaking to Skeebs at the start of the season, and if they made the top four, we'd be pretty happy, but a bloody brilliant effort just to make it to the grand final itself. Maybe they played the grand final the week before, and one of the greatest matches I've ever been involved in, only making 120 odd against the top side of the comp and rolling them for just under 110 or something along those lines. The most pressure-filled win I've ever been in, but one of the most enjoyable wins I've ever been in. I think if we look back at the season, that's one thing that it will stay with me for a long, long time. But right now, here, coming up next, we've got Momo, who's led fantastically for half the season, to do the presentation for the first 11 awards. But before I do, I'd also like to mention Brando, Brandon Speedy, who was anointed captain at the start of the season, wasn't able to finish off the season as captain. But we are looking forward to having him back after round one this season coming. And please don't believe the rumours that said that I was on the panel that got you suspended so I can get in the game of the ones. They are not true. They're no more true than some of the stuff that Red's spouting at the moment. So anyhow, thank you, Brando, for getting us through pre-season and starting the year off as captain. I honestly believe you were doing a fantastic job and had the support of everyone, but really looking forward to having you back as the ones keeper. But right now, here's Momo with the first 11 presentation for this Thursday night. Thanks, guys.
G'day, Toorak-Prahran legends, to whoever's watching. Present players, past players, partners, etc. This is a bit of a weird presentation night. I think this will be hopefully the first and last time we are doing this via video. But, you know, something a little bit different. Hopefully everyone is well and keeping safe and all that sort of stuff. But so I'll just run through a bit of how the first season went, run through some awards, and then, yeah. So overall, we had a pretty solid season, you would say, by making the grand final for the third year in a row. I guess overall, you could say that is a success. When at one point we didn't know whether we were going to make finals at all, but that was purely a performance-based sort of outcome there. But I think overall as a group, the group really came together and overcome a lot of obstacles throughout the year, which was very, very pleasing to see. We did it the hard way. No 2 weeks were the same. We lost games we should have won. We won games we shouldn't have, sort of thing. But, you know, with that brings growth. And I think this group of players that's been together for a while now really learn a lot throughout the year. It was a highly enjoyable year. And we got through it. Unfortunately, we couldn't get it done when it mattered, but you know, things have got to go your way and it didn't quite go our way on the day. But if you're not winning, you're learning. So I think we would have learned a lot from last year and going into next year. I think we can take away a lot from it. Just firstly, I want to thank a few of the blokes that potentially might be moving on. I'm not going to name names because they might not have made up their final decision and I don't want to write them off prematurely. But you know who you are, and I thank you for, one, your service to the ones this year and for previous years and to the club, because you bring a lot to the club. And, you know, once you're part of Toorak-Prahran, you're always part of Toorak-Prahran, and that's the good thing about this club. But yeah, thank you guys, and wish you well, and you know, you'll be back in the future, I'm sure. So, but anyway, we'll roll on to some awards, and we will start off with the batting aggregate and average, which I'm not sure how many years in a row this fella's won this now, but it must be at least three or four. The winner of this award is Shane Speedy with 404 runs at 33.67. And I think he even missed a few games in there, so that aggregate could be a lot higher, I think. Super consistent player, really good leader, good fella, loves his cricket, and is a good player to have in your team, that is for sure. So congratulations, Speedos. Newly married this year as well. Congratulations there. And the Quinella, the batting average, is another Speedy, but Brando Speedy has wrapped up the batting average with a batting average of 34. In doing so, he's made 238 runs. He had a really good year with the stick. Really played with a lot of freedom, and really went about his business in all forms of cricket this year. And you know, unfortunately, it got cut short at the end there. But you know, rolling into next season, he's in for a big one, I reckon, because he's just playing with that really good freedom and playing his shots, and it's good to see he's really enjoying his cricket. So yeah, batting average goes to Brandon Speedy. Congratulations, mate. The bowling aggregate and average, this one goes to a fellow that bowls a bit of pace, bit of spin. He's been greater, he's really stepped up this year in terms of leadership and really being accountable. That is Timmy Gobbo, taking 27 wickets at 13.67. There's too many games where he just turns the game with the ball, or in the field. One from memory is that South Campbell semi-final. I think he took 6 or 7 wickets. That was outstanding. I think against South Campbell again, he ripped through them again, just bowling off spin. He's very hard to face. And, you know, but in terms of bowling, he stepped up this year. But I think in terms of his leadership and his work around the group this year has been awesome. But, yeah, well done, Timmy, for the bowling aggregate and average. Next on to the fielding award. This one goes to Jordan Moran. Good young fella, really, really consistent performer. Good fella. He's really, really good around the group. Good head on his shoulders. Took the new ball in the grand final, which is no easy feat for a young 18-year-old. But he was a joy to captain throughout the year. And I look forward to sharing the field with him again next year, because he's got a bright future ahead of him, and I think everyone can see that. So congratulations, mate, on the fielding award. And last but not least is our first 11 champion. I'm not too sure whether this fella's won it before. I've got a feeling he has, but if he hasn't, he should have. And that goes to Matty Gobbo. I don't actually have his stats up in front of me, but he's a super consistent player with the bat or ball, and another fellow that's really stepped up in terms of leadership and his presence around the group. He's taken it to a next level this year. His bowling's ridiculous, unplayable at times, and his batting is just destructive. Played some of the best shots I've ever seen this year. His 100 against in a one dayer was huge, opening the batting. He's versatile. He's batted all throughout the order. He's taken the new ball. He bowls first change. He bowls at the end. He can really do it all. And is a real asset to have in the team. And, you know, if he can go to another level next year, who knows? But, like, first 11 champion, Matty Gobbo, hats off to you, mate. That was a super season. And I think you've got bright things ahead. So congratulations. But that wraps up our awards for the first 11. Congratulations to everyone that won an award, but thank you to everyone that didn't. Just on to next season very briefly. I'll wrap it up. Next season, we're looking for blokes to really step it up and players to take ownership of their sort of seasons and step up at training. There's going to be plenty of opportunities for some of those blokes that might have been playing twos or threes cricket who, if they want to take that next step and apply themselves, there's opportunities there throughout the year. I think a few blokes stepping aside, you know, a few blokes retiring, but I look forward to hopefully another successful season. But yeah, just getting some new blokes in there, some new blood, new perspectives. But yeah, I hope everyone has a good off season, and hopefully we'll be able to catch up very soon. Just a few quick thank yous that I may have left out of the previous video. Al Speedy, you know, year in, year out, you rock up and do the books for us today, each week, and it's a huge help, and it's you must have to put up with some absolute dribble on the sidelines, which you endure for 6 or 7 hours on a Saturday. But yeah, thank you very much. It makes our job a lot easier, and you're great to have around the guys, and good, always good for a laugh, and you'll tell us when we're shit, and you'll tell us when we're good, which is all, which is sometimes very, very helpful and needed. But thank you very much, mate. Always appreciated. Alistair Gumley, our coach, it's been a huge, huge help having you around. Your great sounding board, your knowledge, your mentoring of players is huge. And I think it keeps everyone very level-headed, and you're a very calming influence around the club, and especially the ones players, but the rest of the club, I think. And I look forward to working with you again next year. Yeah, thank you. As always, Robbie Airy, my second father. Love your work every year. You're making our teas. You're doing everything for us. Without you, this club doesn't run, and everyone knows that. But thank you again, Robbie. You're a legend, and I look forward to seeing you again soon. But yeah, thank you from the ones. Dougie as well, you know, every Thursday doing the barbecue. You're a true clubman. Thank you, mate. Neil Gumley, our president. You know, you make things work behind the scenes, but and playing our ones, funnily enough. But thank you again, mate, and look forward to working again next year, and working through a few things to you know, better the club and move forward as a club and as a team. To all the other captains that captain this year, thank you very much. I know it's hard, selection's hard, and we get the first pick, but without you guys, you know, it doesn't work. So I do thank you, because we would have put you out a few times. It filters down. But yeah, look forward to going around again next year with you all. And yeah, cheers, boys.